All right, folks, back on the Boss Man Show, champs of the Summit League, the Jackrabbits of South Dakota State, my man, Coach Hendo, Eric Anderson. Coach, what's up, man? How you doing, brother?
Man, Boss Man, it's a special time of year, and in Brookings, South Dakota, everybody's Jackrabbit Nation is fired up, my man.
I hear that, Coach. Man, Coach, man, let me ask you about this, bro. 21 in a row in the Summit League. I mean, that's a record right there in my book, man. 21 in a row in that league where it's tough every night, quality coaching every night. Tell me about this run, man.
Well, I'll tell you what, Boss Man, it's special. It's never been done. You know, it's historical for our league. And like you said, the respect that I have for the other coaches in our league, the players in our league, to be able to do what we just did with the target on our back just makes it that much more special. You know, our guys were terrific. They never looked past the moment at hand, you know, which is really, really hard to do when you're in a one bid league and everybody talks about the tournament. Everybody talks about, hey, the pressure that you have, and for them to just embrace the moment at hand, to believe in each other, and especially that last 3 or 4 weeks when that target on the back just kept growing and growing and growing, and to be able to accomplish what they did under the pressure they did was just phenomenal.
Yeah, because you all was everybody's Super Bowl per se. You was everybody who record wasn't what they wanted to be. They wanted to take you down. And so for your kids to take everybody's best shot every night and still prevail, talks about your kids' mental state, their mindset, and their perseverance to be great and to stick to the game plan and really take it a day at a time.
Yeah, it's special. I mean, you know, the last weekend of the regular season, we have to go as we played at Oral Roberts and then Kansas City, who both of them were playing as good as anybody at the time. And we end up winning in overtime at Oral Roberts, scoring 106 to 102, just an absolute shootout. It just reassured that confidence and that belief in each other. And then to go to Kansas City to do something that's never been done, going undefeated in the regular season, our mentality was terrific. They just embraced that moment. They played their tails off, and then coming into the conference tournament undefeated, that target's bigger than that hawk symbol on your hat. I know that. It got bigger and bigger. The atmosphere in Sioux Falls, you know, there was over 10,000 at each game. Jackrabbit Nation showed up, and they brought us a bunch of energy, and we fed off that energy. And just stayed together and took one game at a time and really embraced the moment. And just says a lot about our kids' mentality, selflessness, and care for each other. They believed in each other. You know, we got down with 3 minutes to go in that championship game and just had 0-0 panic. So it was a really special moment when that buzzer sounded and we were going dancing.
Ask you about that, Eric. How's the huddles, man? Because I know – When you've won so much and it gets tight, and when you got we got really tightened up. How are the huddles, man? Were guys still having that big belief, saying, "Hey, we're good, we're good, we're good"? Because you know, sometimes in the huddles, you can tell you a lot whether they get feeling some panic or they say we're still good. So how are those huddles, man?
It's you know, it's something that we talk about all the time. It's like we're gonna be positive no matter what. You got to believe in each other. You're gonna face adversity every single game, but guess what, brother? In life, it gets a little harder, so I wouldn't worry about it too much. And so that's what we talk about in the huddles, man. It's just like, hey, this is just, let's keep things simple. We're right where we want to be, and we'll get through this. Next possession, what are we going to do? And that's what our team did. Maybe one of its best character traits is they just really enjoyed the moment, never looked too far ahead. We can talk about games, but that's what they did each possession. We break it down into four-minute games. Let's win these next 4 minutes. We win these next 4 minutes, we're going to like where we're at. And so there's never been any panic in any huddle with this group. They've always had a huge amount of belief that we're going to win the game at hand and certainly those next 4 minutes. Now, it certainly helps when you haven't lost since December 15th. Hopefully we forgot how to do that.
Yes, indeed. And I think this helped Jeff too in the championship game, brother. Playing tough games against NDSU. They are tough out. Like, that's a damn good team up there in North Dakota State, man. And you played three knockout, drag out games with those guys and came out on top. So I think that gave you confidence from the league play. They're coming on the championship game, like, look, we play these guys twice, same kind of game. We've been here before. We've had this done before, so let's do it.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Those past experiences that we've had, and especially with North Dakota State. I mean, heck, if we I think the last 15 times we played them, I think there's never been a score it's all one possession games. You know, it's all one possession games. So like you said, boss man, like, we've been here before, man. We got to believe in ourselves. We can't panic. Let's just make sure we control what we can control. Let's make sure we're getting stops on the defensive end. Offense will take care of itself, and let the chips fall where they may.
Tell me about my man, Tournament MVP, Douglas Wilson, doing it for you again, man. Big game Doug, I'm going to call it, man. Tell me about that young man, what he's meant to your roster all year long in this program, brother.
Well, I'll tell you this much. He's a hell of a player. But that's not even his best character trait. He's the one of the best teammates I've ever been around. He always gives credit to other people on his team when at the end of the day, he's a big part of our success. But his versatility on both ends of the floor is absolutely special. Defensively, he'll guard everybody on the floor, 1 through 5. Gives us versatility how we can guard ball screens, whether we switch, whether we are aggressive and show really, really hard. He's very, very physical. And then offensively, we play through him, man. We'll throw it to him on the block as much as we can, and certainly has that capability to score and put the ball in the basket. But maybe more importantly, he's a willing passer. He's a playmaker for us at the 5 spot. And when you can play inside out like that, I think it makes your team super, super efficient. And that's probably a big part of why we lead the country in 3-point field goal percentage. And we're one of the top 2 in scoring in the whole country. So Doug's a big part of that.
And the big time bomber you got, man, is Mr. Easley from downtown Charlie, man. Making those threes out of me and Kevin Herter and Bob Donovich when they go up with their own. Tell me about that young man.
Charlie's been terrific for us. I mean, he's probably one of the toughest defenders that I've ever coached. He's a gamer. He just loves to compete. We write three things on our board underneath our game plan every time: 50-50s, kills, and rebounds. And those are toughness plays. That's all about toughness. And there's probably, as far as that character trait, Charlie's as tough as we got. He made so many winning plays in that championship game that go unnoticed, hit big time shots. And so he gets a lot of credit for his defense, but offensively, the man's got great swagger. He's got great confidence. And his teammates and coaches have the same in him.
No doubt. And we're trying to touch on a little bit, Eric. 30 win season, man. Tell me about that, man. 30 wins. We took over this job from TJ. Could you imagine having the 30 win season, what you've done this year, man, to this job when you first talked a few years ago, man?
Now, I believed in this team, but 30's a lot. But 30's a lot. And it's a long season. You know, when I took over for TJ, who's done an unbelievable job at Iowa State, when I took over for him 3 years ago, we lost over 95% of our scoring, 90% of our rebounding. And we had a lot of new faces. We had great players, but there was a lot of fresh faces coming in and to seeing what we could do. And they were unbelievably connected. They were committed to winning championships. You know, we won three regular season titles, but we hadn't been back to the dance. It was a little bit of a monkey on our back. And to be able to stay together and to get it accomplished this year, winning 21 straight league games, winning 30 games with the bullseye on our back, it just says a lot about our kids. And it really does make it special.
No doubt. And I was going to ask you about that. I know Rob Bonier told me it's about them losing to App State last year. And the title game fueled his team through the offseason workouts did this year. For your guys, losing to Oral Roberts last year in the semifinals, how much did that use as fuel this year to actually punch through this time and get it done in Sioux Falls?
I mean, it was motivation. There's no doubt about it. I mean, it stung for a long time, and it can continue to drive you. And as a coaching staff, we may be able to remind them of that a little bit every once in a while when maybe we don't think things are going as well as they should. So to hit that subtle reminder about, hey, you want that to happen again? Okay. So that obviously was used as motivation, but also it made you proud in the summer of the Summit League and understood what our league was all about and what that run did for our league by Oral Roberts last year was special. And you're happy for them, but you also say, hey, what about us? Let's try to make that happen too. And so it was a motivation. That's for sure.
No doubt. So man, tell me in the next few days, how do you balance kind of this rest versus rust? So you guys stay sharp, but also get some guys who need some rest as well.
Hey, we're a team that's going to celebrate our successes. I'll promise you that. We're proud of what we've accomplished, but we also want to prepare to make sure we're putting ourselves in the best position to be successful for the next opportunity at hand, which happens to be the NCAA tournament. So we're certainly giving our guys rest. We took yesterday off and are going to take today off again, going to meet as a team and just talk about some logistical things. But then we'll get back at it on Friday with some workouts. Get shots up, make sure they're sweating, feeling good about themselves. We'll do that Friday, Saturday, and then another team deal on Sunday to watch the selection show. Then it's back to work, man. Then it's back to work. Let's see what we can do.
I hear that, brother. Well, hey, look, when I look at that bracket, I'll be cheering for you, brother. I guarantee you that, man. I'm going to be cheering for you. Hope you get an upset, man. You make your run this year in 2022, brother.
I always appreciate getting on the show with you, man. You do a hell of a job.
Thanks, bro, Eric. Hey, man, be safe, brother. I'll talk to you real soon, my guy.
All right, my man. You take care.
See you now.